What's up, guys? How you doing today? Welcome back again. I'm your boy, this is Adam's Link. Welcome back to another crazy video. Please try as much as possible to like this video, comment, share it on all social media platforms. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Adam's Link Media. Don't forget to subscribe, click that bell notification to get updated anytime I upload. So, guys, let's discuss about Nedowoko documenting another interesting topic surrounding the entertainment industry in Nigeria. Firstly, Nedowoko. Recently, Nedowoko had an interview vividly saying that he's still going to marry many wives because he loves children. He never said because he loves women. So the reason why Nedowoko is getting married to many wives is because he loves children, not women. And recently, a Zambia lady, very beautiful, yellowish, no light in complexion, and of course, that is exactly Nedowoko's type of women, recently posted pictures of her hanging out with Nedowoko and shared a picture of her hand while she was holding someone's hand. Apparently, that person is black. So, if this woman shared pictures of Nedowoko and a few minutes later shared this kind of picture, definitely the answer is not far-fetched. It's simple. Maybe she's one of those women that Nedowoko have been hanging out with, or maybe trying to wife again. Meanwhile, Regina Dani said that she doesn't have any problem with her husband getting married to as many wives as he wants. This is what he said. He said, "I love my husband, Nedowoko. Nedowoko is an amazing father, and that's what is important to me. He knows me so much love. He showed me so much love, more than any younger man ever can. I am happy, last wife or not. As a matter of fact, my husband Nedowoko can marry more wives. It has never been a problem." Well, it seems like all those women that Nedowoko has been marrying is that they already made a conclusion that, see, as long as this man treats us well, give us money, give us the fancy lifestyle that we deserve, then all is well with us. Then he can choose to marry as many wives as possible. But a lot of fans think that Regina Daniel is truly passing through a lot. A lot of fans don't see the genuine happiness that she is talking about. The other day she was seen under the influence of alcohol driving. She goes to party a lot. She posts pictures of her ex-boyfriend Sumudina always on social media. So fans don't see that genuine happiness that she is talking about. Meanwhile, guys, I have a special guest that's going to join us today. We had a little section, so let me share you the video. Hello, how are you doing, girl?
I'm fine, Adam Slink.
Welcome.
Good morning.
Welcome to the program. Please,
I just want to ask
you a few questions. You know, you have been following this Regina Dani issue. So what do you have to say about her mom, particularly concerning her marriage to Nedowoko?
I think my own opinion.
Yeah.
My own opinion, I think her mom used her to achieve her aim, her political aim, and for being fame. Her mom wants to be known in the society more than the way she has been known. So she used her daughter to achieve her aim.
So you mean Regina Dani was like a sacrifice? A sacrifice in the family?
To the family.
For them to have a better life. So
yes,
she doesn't really care about the happiness and everything.
Sorry, come again, please.
You think her mother doesn't really care about Regina Dani's happiness?
What I think is her mom was thinking that maybe if Regina Daniels gets to marry Nedowoko, it will make him stop marrying other wives, being that she's an actress. So Regina Daniels' mom was like, maybe if my daughter gets to marry this man, being the youngest one, he might stop. But with all we've heard from the horse's mouth, we don't think he's gonna stop anytime soon. Like, with my own understanding, it's my own opinion, or you push them fry and eat me. I think he doesn't love his wives. Maybe he might love his first and second, but the other one, I don't think he loves them. All he said in his video was that he loves kids. He never talked about loving his wife. He said he loves kids, that he wants to have more kids. He wants to have plenty of kids. So all we can see in him is that he loves kids, not the ladies he's getting married to, but the children they will provide for him or they will produce for him.
So do you think that a time will come that Reginald Downey might just decide to cheat on him with that guy, that Somodina that she usually posts on her social media, her ex-boyfriend? Do you think she might be careless and now no, just be careless to cheat on him, to cheat on Edowoko?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so because we have a tradition in Delta State. A man that paid your bride price, provided you are still together, you can't cheat on him. It's a taboo. It's a taboo. And mind you, apart from paying her bride price, Edowoko used her. He used her to swear some oaths. From tradition oaths, which I don't believe she can ever cheat on him. I'm sorry for her, but it's the bitter truth. She's missing her ex. She's regretting not being with him. That's why she posts his pictures or his video all over. But if you can see, Edowoko has never made a comment about any of those videos or any of those pictures because he is 100% sure that she can't do it, except she doesn't love her life no more.
And maybe he doesn't really care. He doesn't really he doesn't love her enough to be troubling herself concerning that photos and everything.
But with everything we are saying, Edowoko doesn't love his wives. He never talked about, I love them. He said, I liked her when I saw her and I got married to her.
His recent interview contradicts what Rita Daniel said, that Reginald Daniel was the one that introduced Edowoko to her, that it's pure love.
Yeah, everybody knew she was lying that time. If you watch, so many people came for her, and both mothers. You know, so many people came for her. You understand? So she was just like looking for a way to put her head inside so that it will look as if, okay, yes, the little girl was in love or she's in love. That's why she wants to get married to him.
Well,
you understand? But with everything we've heard from him.
Well, I think it's like 50-50. They got all the money and money they want. And of course, in return, Reginald Downey has to live in bondage.
Well, if you say so, I think it's something like that because right now, with what is happening to her, with what we are seeing on social media, with the kind of life she's living, it shows that she's really regretting where she is today. She's not 100% happy. She might have the money. She might have, you know, maybe she might be recognized
everywhere in society.
Everywhere, yeah, she might be recognized right now, but that joy isn't there.
Okay, now, Elena, thank you very much for staying tuned. Guys, thank you very much, Elena, for coming through for your boy. And please, you can also leave your opinion, leave your comments. So before I leave this Edowoko issue, this Philip Thompson, the lady that was seen currently with Edowoko, I think it's one of his wives, I don't know, still did what she wrote 5 days ago on a Facebook page. She said, "I'd rather be in a polygamous relationship marriage and know my position and be loved, respected, and protected than be in a relationship with one undeserving person who has no respect for me and is connecting to every wife pulse, then accusing me of infidelity. It is less edic." So, well, guys, leave your comments and tell me exactly how you feel about it. Then let us move over to documentary. But first, this former BB Ninja housemate, Princess, said She was once approached by Nedowoko for marriage, but she wasn't wise enough to accept his marriage proposal. She wrote, "Can I officially state that I am done dating for love? I mean, I am now wholly available for self-investment, intensive funding, best regard." Then somebody asks her, "Lo, so Nedowoko should finally apply?" Then she said, "Indeed, when I was younger, I didn't have sense." So apparently maybe she's regretting for not accepting to marry Nedowoko. Well, guys, meanwhile, Dr. Mighty has revealed that his wife and his mother-in-law were planning to have him killed and seize all his property. According to him, his wife confessed to him straight. So it's a very, he came on his Instagram account and revealed, writing a very long statement, which if I should start reading it, guys, we won't leave here. So I'm just going to, I've already summarized it, so I'm just going to read it. So in the letter post shared via social media page late Thursday, November 4, 2020, the musician narrated how his wife openly confessed to him about how they plan to kill him by fetish means, diabolical means, and take over his property. According to the singer, back in March, after showering his wife with some documents of property for her and her family, they decided to have a night getaway from their kids. Then, in the midnight after the Royal Rumble, he was woken up by his wife, who was frightened. When asked what the problem was, Mighty revealed that his wife dropped the bombshell. She confessed that her family had held a meeting where they planned to kill him and take over all his properties because he was an only child. However, after getting several instructions from the native daughter, the plot to kill him failed. In her confession, Vivian revealed that she was told to cut his toenails and bring them for the ritual. So according to Duncan Mighty, his wife, the mother of his kids, so they have been married for a long time now, they have three children. He's saying that his wife revealed to him, confessed to him that her family were trying to kill him because to take away his property, being that he, Duncan Mighty, is the only child of his parents. Well, it's quite really, really crazy. But for Dr. Mighty to come out to be talking this kind of stuff, he didn't just talk, he revealed so much details. Now he's calling out the mother-in-law, the wife, and the brother-in-law, accusing them of trying to kill him. Well, guys, I'm still going to be updating you about what is going on with that family. But as of now, that's just all we know. He said he's going to reveal, that he's going to release the pure confession, the tape, the confession of his wife, that he has a tape. And now his mother-in-law and his brother-in-law and his wife are planning on destroying him on social media, using social media, not coming after him on social media. So that is why he's coming out to talk now. Well, guys, and don't forget, Dr. Mighty was the one that came outside the other day and he said that if your wife is driving a car and your mother is striking, then you are a big fool. That's what she said. And also, Dr. Mighty also shared a picture some time ago while he was traveling somewhere wearing a live tortoise around his neck. So guys, I'm not going to be updating you like I've said before. So for now, that's just how we know concerning documenting. So we are talking about fetish wickedness. This is what the lady wrote. They said, "My relative died and we were not in good terms because I slept with a man. RIP sis, it's now mine alone finally." Imagine the audacity. Just imagine the audacity. This girl coming out saying that herself and her relative were not in good terms because she slept with a relative husband or a relative man. Now she's dead, and now she's happy that that woman is gone. Man, so people can be really, really wicked, or some people can be really, really, really wicked. And this is what the lady was said. He gave you the D, you gave him the pussy. What's the money for? I think exactly this is what I always tell some ladies who ask for money, who ask for transport after night of enjoyment. Like, you gave me the P and I gave you the D. So why will you be billing me? We both enjoy ourselves. We shouldn't be billing each other. But surprisingly, women think like the payment for our suffering, the payment for us grinding, always working hard to get them satisfied, is through sex. So I say thank you very much for watching. It's your boy Gil Adam Sling. Don't forget to like this video, comment, share it on all social media platforms. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Adam Sling Media. And don't forget to subscribe and click that notification to get updates anytime I upload. Bye.